the...
It was an accident.
What are you cleaning up with? That's a dishcloth, not a floor cloth. That was new yesterday.
Oh, dear me. That's a dry cloth ruined. Tuppence, stay in the drain. Quick, put the house up for sale.
The point is, the dishcloth lives in the sink tidy, and the floor cloth lives under the sink, all right?
And the wicked troll lives under the rickety bridge. And he wants to eat the three billy goats gruff. King Prong.
What do you think you're doing eating them?
I think I'm eating them. Mm, definitely what I'm doing.
You've got a nerve. They're Daryl's favourite.
Well, I hate to say this, Trace, but the prawn sell-by date is a lot earlier than Daryl's parents' sell-by date.
You cow.
What? I didn't send him down.
No, I'm sorry. It's not your fault. It's just I was having this lovely dream. That's Daryl's favourite mug.
Sorry, Trace. It just sort of fell off the table.
Daryl's 1980 West Ham FA Cup winner's mug. I bought him that. It's never even been in the dishwasher.
I said I'm sorry, Trace. If you'd like, I'll go down Upton Park and get him another one, eh? Of course, it'll have to be the 1989 relegation mug.
It's not funny, you clumsy great lump.
Calm down, Tracy. You can't keep this up for the rest of the century.
What are you getting at?
Ever since the boys got sent down, you have been impossible to live with.
Yeah, well, there's a simple solution to that, then. Sling your hook.
What I'm saying is, why are you punishing yourself?
I'm not punishing myself. They're punishing me. They've put the man I love behind bars. It's all right for you. You was pleased to see the back of your Chris.
Didn't mean I wanted to see him locked up. I'd have been just as happy if he'd gone off to live with Salman Rushdie.
They never think of the wives when they send the men to jail, do they?
Of course they think of the wives. They think we're a bunch of old slags who's had the benefit of our husband's ill-gotten gains and deserve an hard time when they get banged up. Well, I ain't gonna cop for that. I'm gonna get on with me life.
That is not a kind of joke. So phone now on 499-2191 and win your very own autographed Jason Donovan calendar.
What do you think you're doing?
You heard him.
But you don't even like Jason Donovan.
Shut up. Trace, I'm through! I'm through! Hello? Oh, hold it. Yeah. Yeah, I'm Sharon of Edmonton. No, I ain't. I'm Sharon of Chigwell. Yeah, I just moved. What question? I didn't hear no question. I didn't hear no question.
That phone costs money, you know.
Did you hear a question?
What on earth have you felt like helping with this bill?
Oh, your money made you are.
Hang about. What's all these 0898 numbers? They're the ones you ring up and someone talks dirty to you for 50p a minute, aren't they?
No. It's only 38p off peak. Anyway, how do you know all about them?
Because I once caught Garfy using his dad's car phone, talking to sexy Sadie, all about, you know.
No, what?
Dirty things.
Like how to change an oil filter and that.
You know what I mean, it.
Tracy, the hunk line isn't dirty as such. It's more sort of romantic. There's this bloke with this really kind of deep voice, but horny with it. A bit like Alistair Burnett. Anyway, he sort of talks to you. It's quite erotic, really. I phone it up sometimes late at night when I can't sleep. Helps me to relax.
Yeah, well, judging by this, you've been falling asleep with a phone off the hook. Look, it's got to stop, Shao. I know blood's thicker than water and all that, but it ain't as if you ain't got your own place to go to.
Yeah, but I ain't on the dock there, am I?
Don't take the mick, Sharon.
Look, seriously, if I went, who'd keep you company, eh?
Well, if it's a choice between company and bankruptcy, I'll talk to myself.
Bankruptcy? Oh, do me a favour. You're rolling in it. This house, two cars, money in the bank. Daryl's left you well set up.
So what if he did? He still don't grow on trees. Have you got any idea what this house costs to run?
No, have you?
No. Daryl took care of all the big bills. The point is, it costs a sight more to run this place than a council flat in Edmonton.
Well, I'd worked that one out for myself, Trace. I mean, I thought it'd be a bit more than what I pay for my flat. Seeing as you've got an indoor pool and I've only got condensation.
You're lucky lucky to have a council flat. Some people have to live in cardboard boxes.
Oh, you'd know all about cardboard boxes, wouldn't you? Eh? What with your new fridge, new cooker, new telly, new dishwasher? God, dear me, you must be solving the housing crisis single-handed.
You've got to pack them in something.
So what you're saying is you think it's time I went?
No, I...
I've outstayed my welcome?
No.
So you want me to stay?
Well, of course.
You've twisted me arm.
All I'm trying to say is you could make a bit more of a contribution instead of poncing off me all the time. I mean, after all, you have got your own job to go to.
Go back to low price? But I hate it.
Oh, of course you hate it. It's a job, isn't it? You've hated every job you've ever had. I bet you'd find something to complain about if your job was testing condoms with Don Johnson.
No, I wouldn't.
Hello. Are you all right, Tracy? The curtains were drawn.
I was watching a video, Dorian.
Oh, something racy. Have I missed much?
Come in, why don't you?
Oh, home movies. Oh, good-looking husband you've got there. You want to keep an eye on him.
I've got a pretty fair idea where he's going to be for the next 8 years, thank you.
Sorry.
Dorian, this is my husband I'm looking at. These videos are the remnants of our life together. Do you think I'll put all this makeup on to watch Blankety Blank?
No, no, of course not. Look, I'll go. I'll come back at a better time. How's your diary for 1995?
Empty. Like all my diaries till Daryl gets that. Look, I'm sorry I'll bit your head off. Is this a social visit or did you just want to borrow a sack of coal?
Well, actually, I'm collecting for Greenpeace. They put me on a committee.
You? I wouldn't have thought you'd be into all that.
Just because I don't ruin my clothes with badges.
All right, how much?
No, no. It's for the charity shop. It's old clothes I want. Anything. Last year's Kenzo. A Jasper Conran you shouldn't have brought, but you couldn't resist it. When you got it home, it clashed with your Catherine Hamnet.
What are you on about?
Designer labels, household names.
But I always thought household names meant Ajax and Rice Krispies.
You mean your clothes aren't designer?
Well, some of them are and some of them aren't. And some of the ones that aren't, are.
Come again?
Well, for example, Sharon's brother-in-law, George, has got a factory in Stoke Newington, what turns out, T-shirts. He wholesales for a quid a piece. You can buy them down Romford Market for £2.50 or down South Moulton Street for a score. So what's the difference?
Well, you're not just buying the T-shirt, dear. You're getting an exclusive carrier bag, too.
Your trouble is you're such a snob.
No, it's no trouble, I assure you.
Well, as it happens, I do have a few things you can have for your shop. But I'm not sure the labels are up to it.
Oh, Tracy, please. Anything you have to give will be gratefully accepted. I mean, the sort of people who buy at charity shops. Down and outs, abandoned wives, Michael Foote. Well, they aren't as fussy.
All right, come upstairs then.
Thank you, dear. And if they're really dreck, we'll hang them at the back. Oh, lovely.
What about shoes?
Yes, lovely. We sell menswear too.
What?
I was just wondering, I mean...
I can't part with any fit of Daryl's.
No, OK, only, well, it'll all be out of fashion by the time he gets back.
Such fashion? These are his clothes, understand? They're part of him. They got his smell on them. Sometimes at night I lay one of his suits next to me on the bed with the lights out.
Sounds exactly like my sex life with Marcus. Actually, maybe Daryl's suits move around a bit more. I love this shirt.
I got it for Daryl to wear at the party we was going to have when he got acquitted. He's never even seen it.
You've got a tissue?
What? Oh, hang on. What's the matter?
There's this shirt. I never even saw him in it.
Well, of course you never. Daryl's never worn it. I've just told you.
Not Daryl. Luke.
What, your kitchen-fitting toy boy?
I bought him this exact shirt last week. I just thought he'd look so sexy in it, and I'd hardly given it to him when he tells me he doesn't want to see me anymore. He didn't even wait to get the pins in the cardboard dog collar out. Said he met some young student teacher he really likes. There's no future going out with a married woman, he said. You'll never leave your husband. He said, I'm just a bit of fluff to you, he said.
Well, he is right, isn't he?
But I love him.
Then why don't you leave Marcus and set up home with this loot?
Because I don't want to be poor again.
Again?
Tracy, no one in Chigwell except Marcus knows what I'm going to tell you now. You've got to swear you'll keep this a secret.
I'll swear.
Before I got married, I lived with my parents in the top half of a house in Colindale.
No, you never.
Yes. My poor father over Sholem sold fabric in my Uncle Lou's shop. My Uncle Lou had a Humber Super Sniper house in Wilsdon when it was something to be proud of, and a flat in Eastbourne. And my father, he had a heart attack. What's funny?
Oh, I'm sorry, Dorian, but I never thought you was working class like us.
Do you mind? I am not working class. I'm Jewish. I'd better go.
Now, come on, don't get all stroppy. Look, if you really love this loot, you'd just have to fight to keep him, wouldn't you? If it was me, I wouldn't give up so easy.
You're right, Tracy. Why should I let some 19-year-old bimbo with blonde hair, perfect skin, long legs, perp breasts and firm bottom make all the running? I've got something she hasn't got.
Cellulite?
Money. Well, Marcus's money, to be precise. I'll buy Luke that wild silk suit from Emporio Chacomani I know he loves. £700, but this is war. Fancy trip to Kensington?
Yeah, all right. Why not? You're funny. You're the first person to make me laugh since.
Oh! Oh.
£250 apricot halves and heavy syrup.
34p.
34p. That's what I said.
Sharon, didn't expect to see you back. I mean, not yet.
Well, my doctor said it'd do me good to get back to work. Be among me friends, you know. Morning, Mrs. Hicks. Mrs. James. Had a good look, have you? Anyone would think you'd never seen a gangster's mole before. So what till do you want me on, then?
Well, under the circumstances, I don't mean any personal slight, but all things considered, I better put you on the delicatessen and cold meats for a couple of days.
Cold meats? Oh, I see. What you're saying is you don't be near the money. My husband's a convicted felon, so I'm tarred with the same brush. Guilt by association. I've been here 10 years. I've been here longer than what you have.
Sharon, I know you're as honest as the day is long.
Clock's going back tomorrow night.
But if you're till short at the end of the day through no fault of your own, then head office just might think...
that I'm a thief. All right, fair enough. I hear ya. Cold meats it is, then.
It's a beautiful suit, isn't it? The trousers are half-lined.
It looks fantastic on you, doesn't it, Tracy?
What?
Doesn't Andrew look great?
Yeah, lovely. You got some neck asking a stranger to try a suit on for you.
He works here.
Oh.
Your son's very lucky getting a suit like this for his birthday.
Well, you know how fashion-conscious 14-year-olds are.
Well, it's hard to believe you could have a teenage son.
I love the old lines.
What, son?
I didn't want to tell him it was for Luke, did I? It might put him off.
Off what?
Off me.
What do you mean, off you?
Well, you saw him. He's gorgeous.
Yes, but you're buying this suit to get Luke back. You're crazy about Luke. Remember, without Luke, life is meaningless. You told me that in the car.
And I meant it. Without Luke, my life's a vacuum. But that doesn't mean that I'm not drawn towards masculine beauty. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm a very sexual person.
But he's wearing a wedding ring.
So am I.
Anything else?
Not in the way of clothes.
You're a right tart, you are, Dorian.
No, I'm just in tune to the rhythm of my body. American Express?
Of course. I'll have to phone for a sanction.
Take all day. Do you want my name and address?
That's not necessary for a credit card.
I know, but take it anyway. Don't call after 7 o'clock. And if a man answers, say you're seeking donations to charity and he'll hang up.
Hello? Yes, I'd like a sanction on an American Express card.
Oh, you've got to have these sweaters. They're fabulous.
Yeah, but they're so expensive.
Not for designer labels.
Oh, I don't know why you don't wear your clothes inside out if the labels are saying for them.
I'm sorry, Tracy. I'm being thoughtless.
Well, no more than usual.
No, I mean, with your husband living away from home, so to speak, of course you have to be a little careful with money.
I want for nothing. Daryl's left us very well provided for. Financially, at least. I'll have them both. One for me and one for Garfie.
We'll put them on my bill.
I'm not taking handouts.
I'm not offering. You can settle up with me later.
It's all right, then.
Fine. Thanks. Thank you.
No, thank you.
It's a pleasure to be of service.
I'm glad to hear it. When's your day off?
Just over, all right?
No, I want it exact. I'm not made of money, not like some people around here.
Oh, surprised to see you back at work so quick.
Made your day then, and I.
Quarter of corned beef with no fun, if it ain't too much bother. Ain't seen you at the flat. Been staying with your sister?
Yeah, that's right.
Surprised you after work. What with your old man's stash and your Tracy being loaded and all.
Oh, I don't have to work. I choose to work. To pay me way at Tracy's. I mean, I could ponce off her, but I don't like to. All right. Not that you'd understand.
Meaning?
Meaning the concept of honest labour is one that you've never really come to terms with.
I gotta make ends meet.
Like your end and my Chris's end, for example.
Look, that's ancient history. We had a few drinks, we was in his new Ford Zephyr. He was feeling sorry for himself, seeing as you had gone right off sex.
Oh, that's what he said, was it?
That's what he said.
And you felt sorry for him?
Yeah, I did, as it happens.
So you give him a free sample?
You saying I'm on the game?
I'm saying nothing. But then it weren't me that put postcards up in every sweet shop window in Edmonton. Swedish message. Maybe sexual services are better than your spelling.
Sharon, my office, now.
There's no need. You can give me a check.
Oh, I'd rather give you the cash. Me and Daryl prefer cash. No money? How can I have no money? My husband's a bloody bank robber. Hello, it's Mrs. Stubbs again. What time did Randolph leave? Well, he ain't here yet. I don't give a toss how much traffic there is on the M25. Look, give me his car phone number. Oh, it's all right, that must be him.
His hand, Trace. Couldn't get to me key. Oh.
I'll shut the door, shall I? Oh.
So, then I turned on the old waterworks, didn't I? I said, how did he expect a poor girl on her own to cope without a job? He felt sorry for me. Give me a month's pay in lieu of notice.
Which you instantly blew down Wood Green Shopping City.
Hey? Why shouldn't I?
Well, if you don't know, I mean, you could have offered something towards a phone bill.
Oh, there.
Or the electric, or the gas, or the water rates. And you're always snatting around in that fridge. You spend more time in the jacuzzi than what the plug does.
Hold up, hold up. It's all right for you, Mrs. Moneybags. You give better things to charity shops than what I got. When was the last time I had some new gear, eh? When have I ever had anything really nice? When we was kids, all I had was your hand-me-downs. My first nappy had your skid marks on it. Once in my life, I decided to treat myself. Hey, what's that?
It's a carrier bag. You've seen a carrier bag before, haven't you?
Oh, Trace. Why didn't you say you got us a jumper? Which one's yours?
The red one.
Who is it? I like the red one. Mind you, I like them both, of course. Be on the small side, though.
It's because it's for Garth.
Oh, thanks, a bundle.
I didn't have your size.
150 quid. You hypocrite. I bought two dresses, a suit, three blouses, five T-shirts, a jumper, two pairs of shoes, six pair of tights and some naughty knickers, and it never come to 300 quid.
When I bought this stuff, I thought I had money in the bank.
What do you mean, salt?
Well, Dorian laid out for me in the shop. When I went to get her money back out of one of those cash machines, it chewed me card up and told me I was skint. She'll be knocking on the door any minute now for a 300 quid. What am I going to do?
Oh, don't ask me. In our flats, we do a runner if a neighbour comes to get a cup of sugar back.
If only you'd show me a bit more consideration.
Don't start all that again. I ain't psychic, am I? How was I to know you was down and out in Beverly Hills? Look, if you're really in trouble, I'll take my stuff back tomorrow, get you some credit notes.
Sharon, I can't give Dorian a CNA credit note. She'd rather have Colonel Gaddafi round for drinks than be seen dead in CNA.
Oh, well, if that's your attitude, you're just as bad as she is. Right pair of snobs. You know what your trouble is, don't you? You've forgotten your roots. Well, I ain't. I'm working class and I'm proud of it. And I ain't going to stand round here and be insulted. I'm going to go up and have a jacuzzi, then I'm going to the wine bar. They got that Beaujolais Nouveau gear in this week. Can I borrow your heated rollers?
No.
Not bad for a chain store, Shell. Even though I say it myself. If you don't pull tonight, girl, might as well become a nun.
Detective Inspector Monk, Serious Crime Squad. You don't mind if we turn your gaff over? Do you, darling?
I don't believe this. But what are they looking for up there? Am I allowed to open my own front door?
Oh, have I called it a bad time?
Yes.
Anything I can do?
No. Oh, Randy, thank God. Where have you been? Come on. What's going on, Randy? I've been trying to phone you.
Yeah, and I was trying to phone you, but you were engaged.
That tow-rag Monk's upstairs with a search warrant.
I know, look. Do you mind, love? Isn't Mrs. Stubbs entitled to some privacy when she's talking to her solicitor?
You ain't me solicitor, aren't you? You're me accountant.
She don't know that, though, does she?
What are they looking for? I mean, they searched the house three times while Daryl's on remand.
Yeah, but last night they pulled someone who's put his hands up to being on a big job Daryl's supposed to have done back in 87. A pal of mine at your bank's head office tipped me the wink.
Yeah, but what's that got to do with freezing my bank account and everything?
It's obvious, Tracy.
Well, not to me, it's not, Randy.
Look, the police never believed that all this was bought with kosher money, did they?
But why not? I mean, Daryl's legit business was doing terrific. He couldn't erect his conservatories quick enough.
The business still wasn't making a sort of money that buys a million quid house, two new cars every year, Garth school fees.
£1 million?
Of course, didn't you know?
Daryl took care of all the bills.
Exactly. So if the police can prove that this house was bought with the proceeds of crime, they can take it away from you and put you out on the street.
They can't.
Well, I bet. They can even bang you up for receiving.
But, I mean, if Daryl did do a big job 3 years ago, they're hardly going to find a sack of money under the bed now, are they?
They're not looking for money. The grass says Daryl did that wholesale jewellers in Hatton Garden. Look, it was in all the papers and he got away with nearly half a million's worth.
When was this exactly?
February the 12th, 1987. I hope you didn't get any really nice Tom for Valentine's Day that year.
Oh, my God. My diamond ring.
What?
It's on my ring tree.
Which you keep in a safety deposit vault in Geneva.
Which I keep on my dressing table upstairs.
I hope you've got a nice warm nighty, Tracy, because they're not into central heating in Holloway Prison.
Of course, I make a tidy bit on the side doing jobs for my mates in there. I mean, Telecom pays the rent, but it's private work what runs XR3i. Have a drink.
I'll have a champagne cocktail, please.
Over here, John. Champagne cocktail and a lager. So, you celebrating something then?
Yeah, I had a bit of a windfall today.
Oh, very nice.
So, what do you charge?
Do you mind? Why, that sort of like.
For an installation, I mean. No, I could do it with my own phone. My sister keeps getting the amp when I use hers all the time.
What, wrap it into the fiancé, are you?
What fiancé? I am engaged. I like the telephone.
Right. Cheers. So what's that big diamond ring all about then?
Oh, this? No, it's a bit of costume jewellery I lent off my sister.
Yeah? I don't reckon that's no cubic zirconia. I reckon that's a business.
Get off. Just wanted an excuse to hold my hand, didn't you? This was a real diamond. It cut glass, wasn't it? See?
Ah. And I thought I'd pull the millionaires tonight, the way you'll turn out.
This? 25 quid in CNA sale.
I like a woman who's careful with money.
Does that mean you take me home tonight, then?
I'll drink to that.